this material on this tie is really flimsy. I think I could get it first time, but I've done it hundreds of times and I'm still learning. My mum told me when I first started as a photographer, she's like, you need something that's like unique to you. She's like, something that people don't forget. So like, have a hat or a bow tie, or, and I always thought she was stupid. She was always, and then I started wearing bow ties. It's actually my dad's old camera bag. My dad passed away when I was a kid, but handed on to me love of photography and also his camera gear. So that's sort of where it all started for me. Should do a bit of a selfie with it. Not that one. I'm hopeless with selfies. The first time I'll ever be, and probably the last time I'll ever be mic'd while shooting a wedding, hopefully. This is probably the most important of the camera bags, which is actually just salad and fruit and things, because you're never quite sure if you're gonna get fed. And you can't leave anything to chance, so. I'm a little bit sick at the moment, which is always a challenge for shooting. But then, you know, you have these crazy days and crazy weather where you might not be home till 2 a.m. It's really, really hard to not get sick. So in wedding season, I'm finding that I'm sick at least half the time. Yeah, it's pretty crappy weather. Yeah, my poor old wife, she's a patient lady, because I mean, I'm out every weekend, meetings at nights. She has a 9-to-5 job, Monday to Friday. Socially, it's difficult. It's really difficult. It's a big sacrifice, I think, being a wedding photographer. And not just a part-time wedding photographer, but a full-time where you're on the go pretty much every weekend. You need to be able to pay the bills. I think there's a lot of people out there who, you know, they might follow photographers or whatever, or, you know, they see this like glamorous lifestyle. Because I mean, you want to, obviously, when you're marketing yourself, you don't want to make your job look like it's crap, you know, or too difficult, or, you know, there's all that. There's too many challenges or anything, but you know, the fact is, it's a huge sacrifice for starters, as I was saying about always working. I basically work when my friends play. There's always that nervousness that did I actually look at this right? Am I here at the right time? But we're all good. actually one thing I've noticed over the years is that probably every wedding I photograph, I dress just slightly more casual than I did the wedding before. Remember the first weddings I shot was full suit and tie, like it was like a $300 Versace tie that I bought in Paris, and it was my thing. And to me, it was all about turning out and looking sharp. And I realized that those clothes are just getting in the way. I actually rarely sleep before a wedding, and I don't know why. So I'm actually used to photographing on very little sleep. I might have got 3 hours last night. But it's just always been something. Never been able to sleep before a wedding. Hopefully that changes one day. The industry at the moment's in an interesting place. I mean, it was quite telling for me. The other day, when I was photographing a wedding just on Friday, 2 days ago, I ran into a guy in Centennial Park who, to me, embodied success when I first started. And, you know, he had his big fancy studio right near the city, right in a major road. Yeah, and I ran into him, and actually, coincidentally, a day or two before, I drove past the studio and saw that it was now empty. I went and introduced myself as I was shooting, because I just saw him there, and he basically said to me, "Mate, feel free to send any work my way." Definitely becoming more and more of a younger man's game, where you've got people who are coming into the market with a little less experience than is probably ideal, have probably learned a lot through forums and Facebook, and you know, might have gone to a workshop or two, you know, like any market, coming in and undercutting people. But I don't think it's all bad. I think you know, those photographers, because they don't necessarily know what they have to do. Like, they're not sort of versed on, well, this is what wedding photography is. It's meant that it's kept the game really fresh. I think there's a lot of guys out there who are... Look, I sound like I'm an old bloke. I'm 29. I'm still, you know... I mean, I've been doing it now for 11 years, but, you know, I sit somewhere in the middle there, where I'm young, but I've been doing it for a while, so I've seen sort of people come and go already, which has been interesting. So last year, I started, we had a whole, I think I probably had like 8 or 10 weddings in a row where it rained. And I was sort of forced to adapt. So I ended up trying to take a few more shots utilizing the rain. Yeah, I found that I was able to adapt a little bit to this sort of rainy weather. Since I've started sharing some of those shots, I've actually had clients say to me, "I hope it rains," which actually blows my mind that a bride would say to me that they hope it rains on their wedding day. Quite a selfish shooter when I shoot a wedding. I shoot for me all day. I shoot what makes me happy. I shoot what gets my attention. I shoot what I want to remember. And the story that I want to tell. I find that then the clients respond really well to it because, you know, my passion was injected into everything I shot. There's always a bit of nervousness as you're about to go in. So you're never really quite sure what you're gonna see, what you're gonna face. Why am I doing what I do? Oh man, so many things that have culminated for me to really appreciate holding on to moments. You know, I lost my dad when I was a fairly young kid, and I just found that, treasuring the people in your life and treasuring the moments, and just celebrating life was something that was so important to do. You never know when it's going to be too late to tell someone that you love them or to celebrate them. I think the real value in it is to remind them of the commitment they made and the celebration that they had of the love that they share, but in the moments where time potentially isn't so ideal for them, where the moments aren't so happy, where they've got those reminders that, hey, you know what, people celebrated the fact that we joined up, we got together, and we celebrated the fact that we got together. So I think having images that remind you of that is so important. Hey, what's happening? I'm just kidding. Oh, no. No, can I get you to walk away from me further? If you can walk, yeah. So see where the path is just behind you further away? If you can go just beyond there and then just walk away hand in hand. If you can go probably 5 metres beyond that, just walk there hand in hand and then turn around and come back. Next to you is the person who you've just committed basically your life to, the rest of your life, together. The person whose hand you're going to hold through so many crazy life experiences. Maybe babies. Lots of fun times, some difficult times. That person right next to you right now is going to be the one who will be there with you. And what I want you to do, when I say go, I want you to turn, open your eyes and look at each other. And just with the way you look at the other person, show them just how excited you are that they're the one who you're holding. You ready? The hardest bit is probably finding the balance between giving direction, but then allowing spontaneity and keeping that natural connection alive. Because I think as photographers, we can get in and we can try and take over and say, hey, this is my view of you guys. Whereas I like to more and more ask questions that invite them to put more and more of them into the image. With the individual portraits I was getting of the people, just by having the people who they're good friends with them and, you know, the people who they're best friends with, yell and scream things at them and whatever, just helps them relax and be dumb and just brings out their natural personality. If they're naturally a bit of a show pony, then they can be that. If they're naturally shy, then that'll come out too. If they're, however their natural state is, that's what you'll say. So rather than saying, hey, turn your head this way, da 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 da, and what a great way for the couple to remember their friends by when they go back and they're like, you know, that's our friend, he's a bit of an idiot, likes to have a good time, rather than just, well, that's how our photographer saw them and he saw them as a boring person who should just stand in. Typically, family photos are some of the more boring parts of the day. But then you've just got to remember. Well, I know for me, I know that from my wedding, the family shot. It's up in my wife's grandmother's house. Like it's the prize shot from our wedding day. And she loves it. So just knowing that those images will be loved by someone. Helps me love the moment too, and helps me take it really seriously and actually appreciate those times. It helps me make sure that I'm helping those people connect when I'm taking those family photos, so that they're taken back to that moment where their family was connected, because it might not always be like that, and eventually we're going to lose all those people as well, which is tough. Future of the industry. Video and photo have to become one, I think, in some ways. I think for 95% of people long term, they'll be hiring someone who'll be doing both. I just can't see, because there's such an overlap. Like, we're shooting the same stuff, and I don't know. I think that has to meld into one. Yeah, I think it's going to get harder and harder because everyone is going to be a photographer. And I mean, the technology is getting so good that it's just not hard to take a photo. I think there's always going to be a place for true artists, basically. You know, someone with a real vision for the image. And someone with, yeah, something special, a unique way of looking at things. There's always going to be a place for that, but there's going to be less of a place for everyday wedding photographers. I definitely love the teaching aspect. Love imparting knowledge. My dad was a teacher, and he wrote books and things like that as well. So that definitely runs in the blood, and I can see myself, writing a few things and teaching more, and just helping others enjoy their work more and to create better stuff. Yeah, I just want to enjoy life to the full. So I'm gonna continue to search for the right balance so that I can enjoy life more and more.